Stuff. Now joining us on the art scene for more on the rare collaborative performance, acclaimed composer and musical director Jesse Lucas and theater actress Banaue Miclat-Janssen. Well, we'll start by saying good morning to you, Jesse. I mean, good morning. What a real pleasure. And that was a beautiful piece that sung by Banaue over here. I don't know where to start. I mean, I need to be filled in a little more on the work of Maningning. I mean, you know, who can help me here?
Okay, I came up with the idea after reading her book, her collection of poems, Voice from the Underworld. And then I asked the permission of the family and with Banaue if we can collaborate. I composed music for most of the poems in Tagalog and English, and while Banaue will be performing the songs.
It looks like it's a fantastic collaboration. I mean, that was beautiful. Tell us a little bit about you know, how you best remember your sister, her work, what was really the root and soul of the work that she did.
Well, actually, in the beginning, before the project, I was always because she was my sister, I had that, like, you know how you take things for granted because, you know, she's just my sister. I know she has a book of poetry. I know she's done exhibits and stuff. But it was through this project that I got to know her works better. And it's such a healing process for me. It's been 15 years since she passed away, but it's just it's been a healing process, an understanding of her life and probably why she died early, you know. So so this project, Jessie's music understood her words, and it was just so easy to sing because of that marriage of, you know, the words and the music. Mm-hmm. So
how do you start putting something like this to music? I mean, poetry has has a rhythm of its own, has a mood of its own. How do you sort of build on those flavors and come up with something that's really worked out to be as beautiful as it is?
As a composer, I'm used to draw images from visual images, because I do film and theater works.
Right.
I draw inspiration from the narrative, but this time the inspiration came in very quickly through the words she painted, the mental images she painted through her words. Mm-hmm. It was very easy.
Well, I mean, her work is unique in that. Mm-hmm. I mean, she was she was so talented in so many departments. I mean, there was her visual work, and there was there was her writing, which all seemed to sort of can all seem to come together towards giving you, like you said, sort of a better visual picture of how to translate her writing anyway into music. How do you choose what particular pieces of her poetry go into this particular?
During the creative process, we chose the works that talks about the joys of falling in love, mm-hmm. the pain of falling in love, mm-hmm. The beauty of life in general.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then, how would you describe the process of? I know when creative people get a hold of material, or materials, if a painter gets new paint, you can't wait to paint, and you stay up all night and you paint. Mm-hmm. When a musician, composer, gets material like this, lyrics that are so juicy. How long did it take? What's the process? How long does it take you? Does it, you know?
Well, like I said, I was very inspired from the words. Mm-hmm. It came very quickly.
Right.
Writing the music and arranging. Mm-hmm.
And I want to ask Banaue, you were talking about how it's a pleasure to perform material like this,
yes,
a great collaborative process. And it's also very personal, obviously, for very
it
obvious
is.
Reasons.
Uh-huh.
You describe it as healing, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
A little bit more on that.
Oh, okay. So the journey of understanding her words with the music is, her manner of death was a little dark, and a lot of people thought that a lot of her life came from dark places.
Right.
But being able to really analyze the text with the music, it showed that there's an aspect of maybe she really did not belong to this world, and she was really borrowed. Mm-hmm. That was the biggest healing process
of
it.
Right.
To be reassured that she really did not belong, to be able to let go of that factor and not cling on to the physical aspect of her body, of her life, and just be reassured that, you know, she left a lot of work for us to know ourselves more than, you know, getting to know her, know ourselves beyond what is the physical body.
Right. That's a great way of looking at it.
Okay,
so what are we in for? There's a one night only musical experience.
Yeah.
What are we in for?
It was originally conceptualized as a concert, but during the creative process, we incorporated dance, movement, visual arts, audience interaction at some point.
Mm-hmm.
So it's totally a unique musical experience.
Okay, so it certainly sounds like something to look forward to. Hit us with those dates. Where can we watch it? Where can we grab tickets? How do we go about
It's this coming May 30 at the UPL Daba Hall. For our first performance, it's by invitational only, but we are planning to do a regular run and at the same time do a recording of the songs.
Good stuff. Well, I have no doubt that people will be interested to catch this particular celebration of your sister's work. Thank you so much to Jesse Lucas.